Let's explore what Copilot Studio is and what it does. And the thing I want to do first here is to frame it up alongside the other Copilots, because this is where it gets confusing and also where there is some overlap. So first up, Microsoft Copilot exists across a lot of different versions. There is a version that is a free version, which is the one that's actually just called Copilot. This is something that you can access on the web, on the mobile, in Windows, to ask questions, to research information, to have it create songs, images, poems, all those kinds of things for you. The one that most people think about when they say Copilot, though, is this one here, which is actually Microsoft 365 Copilot. The one I just showed you is free. Microsoft 365 Copilot comes on top of your Microsoft 365 license. This is an additional $30 per user per month. And this one is connected to all of your Microsoft Graph data at work, your emails, your chats, your documents. It exists in Teams here so that you can do things like, say, help me find the latest document on this or give me an update in this. And it also sits inside those Microsoft 365 applications like Outlook, Excel, PowerPoint, and Word to help you in your line of work with all of the things you do in those apps. And the reason I wanted to take you through this first is because this is where Copilot Studio comes in. This is the piece that allows you to either build your own standalone Copilot for internal or external use, or to extend that Microsoft 365 Copilot so that it can reach more systems and do more things. Let's take a look at what that actually means. So the experience here is that you start off by saying, what do I want my Copilot to do? And you have control here. You're basically starting from something that has the capability of a large language model, similar to ChatGPT, but it's not like ChatGPT in the sense that that's your public facing, out on the web, connected to everything, answering all the questions. That first Microsoft Copilot that I showed you earlier is the Microsoft equivalent of that. This is like starting from the ground up and building it yourself for a particular purpose, and you choose what it has access to. So it doesn't start with access to everything. You give it knowledge in the form of saying, point to this public website or these public websites, or ingesting documents, uploading documents that it then has in its virtual AI brain. You can also point it to SharePoint sites or to Dataverse for internal use cases where the users are going to authenticate in and you want them to be able to access documents in your SharePoint library or information in Dataverse for those kinds of use cases. And you can add a bunch of other third-party external data sources in here as well. So your starting point here, you're building a Copilot and from the ground up saying, here is the knowledge that you have as a Copilot. And then it's using the large language model underneath to answer questions on behalf of the user. This is an example of one that I've got that's connected to a publicly available website. And it actually is able to connect to that knowledge, give a response, and it will give you the citations. But if you ask it random other questions, you've got an option here where you can say, yes, allow it to use the general knowledge of the large language model to answer anything else, or no, tunnel vision. This Copilot is only connected to the knowledge that we give it. So you've got control here. This is very different from that starting point of Copilot or ChatGPT on the web. You decide what knowledge your Copilot has for its particular use case. The other important thing here is that it's not just AI all the time. You actually can do what's called conversational orchestration, which is about controlling the flow of the topic. In almost any scenario, you are going to want certain topics answered a certain way. You don't want to let generative AI answer everything. Think about your brand, how you might want it to respond to certain questions versus how a large language model might just randomly answer those questions. Anything that's, you know, legal or safety or critically important, you want to control the flow of that conversation. And so with Copilot Studio, it's not just about connecting with AI to those knowledge sources, but then you author these topics to say, if someone wants to talk about this thing, here is how I would like you to respond, including this idea of conditional branching logic. And there's a lot of things you can do in here with variables and storing information so that it knows what's going on in the conversation and can come back to it later. You can also have your Copilot take action on behalf of the user by using all of these out-of-the-box Power Platform connectors APIs, plugins, anything that you can connect to, you can set this up so that the Copilot needs certain inputs and provides certain outputs. So classic example here is using something like a weather connector, where you can say, what's the weather in? And it's looking for a city, and it can return that, right through to sophisticated scenarios of triggering approval processes or triggering putting data into other systems. So anything you can do in Power Automate, your Copilot can essentially be the trigger point for that to pass information through, do a thing, and return information back. And there's lots of sophisticated tools in there that allow that Copilot to take action on behalf of the user. And so back to where we started, you can use this to build those standalone Copilots from the ground up, or you can use it to extend Microsoft 365 Copilot. Now, the starting point here is different. This is not a narrow focus where you're saying, I determine what knowledge you have. The Microsoft 365 Copilot already has all of that knowledge in the Microsoft Graph, all of that stuff about your documents and your emails and your chats. So this one is already deeply embedded as your AI assistant at work. But what if you want it to connect to your ERP system or your ticketing system or your something else that's not part of that? So this is where you can use Copilot Studio to extend the skills of that Copilot to go even further and to be able to do other things other than those standard things that it comes out of the box with. Typical starting point for building Copilots. Most people start by thinking about one of these two scenarios, either, hey, let's build an IT help desk system, which typically looks like taking those frequently asked questions away about IT support services and perhaps connecting to a ticketing system of some kind, Dynamics, ServiceNow, Salesforce, some of those kinds of things. And the Copilot can do that because it can have that knowledge about your frequently asked questions and your IT policies and documents and take action to create those tickets and keep the user up to date. The other one is a HR type scenario, which is about saying, let's point it to a SharePoint site which has all our policy documents. And if you don't have the Microsoft 365 Copilot already connected to everything, this is something you can do as a standalone Copilot without paying for that license and then deploy that into Teams. But the real value here comes not just from those business to employee scenarios, but where you start to think of it as a way that you can use Copilot to grow your business. So we're moving from the old idea of saying, oh, it's a retail site and there's a chatbot or an insurance site and a chatbot on the site. We've already seen all of those things for years. Similar concept, but we can go so much further now with these tools of AI and knowledge built in. So think about scenarios that might help grow your business in some way. Can it act as a concierge? Can it help people find the services, make bookings, find available appointments, suggest products, completely reinvent the way you think about customer self-service in terms of the amount of knowledge that it can have access to? You don't have to manually author all those things anymore. Can you point it at a knowledge base and take that really high volume work away from your call center? So this is really starting to revolutionize how we can think about these things. I've got an entire series here on Copilot Studio Essentials that takes you through the core concepts in under 10 minutes. If you'd like to keep learning, I'll see you in the next video.